Good afternoon, I'm Rita Diaz. This is One News Now. The Transportation Department is suspending the use of beep cards for EDSA busway commuters starting tomorrow. This after operator AF Payments refused to waive the cost of the beep cards to the public. Starting Monday, a dual payment system will be implemented, meaning the existing beep cards and off-board cash may be used for payments. Commuters have been complaining about the additional services fee that came along with the automation. COVID-19 cases in the Philippines have breached the 320,000 mark. This after the health department recorded over 3,000 new infections, bringing the case tally to more than 322,000, some 43,000 of which are still active. Meanwhile, over 273,000 Filipinos have gotten better from the disease, with more than 18,000 new recoveries today. The DOH explained that the uptick in the line with the Upland Recovery Program, which is a time-based classification of recoveries. Now, on the other hand, 100 patients succumbed to the SARS-like disease in the past 24 months, raising the death toll to more than 5,700. Now, over 10,500 of the country's COVID-19 cases are recorded among overseas Filipino workers. Based on the latest data from the Foreign Affairs Department, some 3,000 OFWs are currently undergoing treatment in almost 80 nations. The Labor Department, for its part, has stepped up the release of assistance for those affected by the pandemic. The agency said nearly 280,000 workers have received a total of 2.8 billion pesos in cash under the Abot Kamay Ang Pagtulong program. Meanwhile, more key officials may be facing wraps soon as the task force PhilHealth continues its investigation. Senator Panfilo Lacson said Senate President Tito Soto holds inside information which includes evidence pointing to PhilHealth or Health Secretary Francisco Duque III. With this, Duque, along with former PhilHealth President Ricardo Morales, may be put under probe in the second phase of the investigation. Senators have repeatedly called out the Justice Department-led task force for disregarding Duque's alleged involvement in the irregularities within the state insurer. Now, for more updates, follow News 5, the Philippine Star, and Business World Online. Visit our website, onenews.ph, for more in-depth analysis. You can also catch One News on Signal Play app. Register for a free account now at www.signalplay.com and stream One News live anytime, anywhere. I'm Riza Diaz. We are One News.